Hello, this is Dean Knipping from the SynergyDE developer support team, and today we're going to be talking about an issue that sooner or later you may run into, and that's a segmentation violation, SegFault, signal trap, or signal 11 type error. The issue is what to do when you or your end user experiences this type of an issue. First off, it may help to know what a SegFault is. And basically, it indicates that improper memory access was attempted, and SynergyDE has encountered an error that it can't recover from. Okay, that's all fine and good, but what does this mean to you, and more importantly, what can you do to track down the cause of this issue? We have Knowledge Base Article 1569, using the Microsoft Windows Debugger to debug Signal 11 resignaled or segmentation violation errors, and that's what I'm going to walk you through today. When you get these types of errors, there are a few things you'll need to find out to help identify the issue. What's the functionality of the lines of code referenced in the traceback? Does a traceback always reference the same messages and line numbers? Is this a random issue or are you able to duplicate it at will? How often does the error occur? Is this application local to the computer or does it run on a server? If it does run on a server, are you able to move all the executables and libraries locally and see if the issue persists there? If it's isolated to a single machine, does that computer have any other issues as in system crashes or errors, or is it different than any of the other systems that are not having an issue? Also, how many people are affected? Is it just this one person or computer, or does it happen to everybody? In the example I'm going to show you, it's going to be an issue with the application and not isolated to a specific user. In the KBR article, there's a link to download the Microsoft Windows Debugger, and you're going to need to install this on a system that is having a SegFault. While installing the debugger, you're going to be given an option to install multiple tools, but you're only going to need to install IntelliSense and Reference Assemblies in the .NET Development Node, and debugging tools for Windows from the Common Utilities node. Everything else can be unchecked. Once the debugger has been installed, there's just a couple more steps and then we can begin debugging the issue. First, you're going to need to bring up an administrative command prompt. From this command prompt, you're going to cd to the install directory of the Windows debugger, and that is Program Files Debugging Tools for Windows x86. Once you've entered that directory, you just type in windbg space minus I and hit return, and this will go through and set it as the default debugger. Once you've done that, you just click OK. Next, what we're going to need to do is set a couple of environment variables. They do need to be set at the system level, so I'm going to go into the System Control Panel, Advanced System Settings, and Environment Variables. The first variable is sig_core. Its value needs to be 1. The other variable you're going to need to set is a little more odder. It is __NT __symbol_path. Now, what it needs to be set to is SRV asterisk and this section right here, C:\temp. That needs to be a direct read that you have access to on your system. I verified that C:\temp is on my drive and it's good to go for me. After you put that directory, it's an asterisk and then http://msdl.microsoft.com/downloads/symbols. And then you can just click OK and OK and OK. Now that we have the environment variables set up, there's just a few more steps and we'll be ready to debug the issue. First, you're going to need to do the following. You need to launch the Windows debugger. Then you're going to need to launch your application. Now, in this case, I'm launching mine in debug because it's a very simple application and I wouldn't be able to do the next step if I just ran it normally. The next step is going to be attaching the debugger to your application. So you're going to click on File, Attach to a Process. Within this process list, you're going to go through and find the DBR. In this case, it's the very last item because it's this last item launched on the machine. You're going to click OK. You can click No here because you're not going to need that information. Once you've done that, you're going to tell the system to debug. So you click on Debug and Go. Now, in a real-world application, you would just have launched your application and let it sit here. You've attached it to the debugger and you've told it to go. And at this point, you would duplicate the issue. Now, I'm going to do that just by telling my application to go. And as I can see here, it has come back with some information and the system has actually segfaulted. What I need to do now is get that particular view, and that's going to be from the View menu and Call Stack. From within the Call Stack, we need Sources, Adders, in source args. Those three items are going to give us all the information we need to know where in our code we're having an issue. Now you can close the other two windows just to make sure that this next part goes right. If you click on Edit and then Write Window to Text File, this is going to write this window into a file that you can send into us. I'm going to go through and save this as myerrors.txt, and I'm going to be saving that to my desktop. Once you get that file, send it into support and we'll be able to take it from there. Now at this point you could uninstall the Microsoft Windows Debugger and remove SIG core and the NT symbol path environment variables, but I would suggest waiting until you've confirmed that the SegFault has actually been resolved so you don't have to set the system up when we ask you to test the fix. Now once it has been confirmed as resolved, you can remove the Windows Debugger and the environment variables. Thank you for watching, and I hope this helps you the next time you run into a SegFault.